Welcome back, Plant a Tank fans, or maybe we're going to call this Dirt It Tank fans. So anyhow, we finished the dirting process. We've wet down the dirt. I read a very interesting article during the week, and I forget who wrote it, but kind of like to sum it up. They said again, planting using dirt is not a new thing. It's probably a very old thing, and until manufacturers started making the flow rates and the eco completes of the world. But dirting was the way to go. So this is an old technique, not a new technique. But in any event, the person was talking about how when you buy your dirt or your topsoil or your organic material, in this case potting soil, that it's used to being exposed to oxygen. When you wet it down for the first time, bacteria starts to grow, and the bacteria depletes things of oxygen, depletes the soil of oxygen. So they suggested in the article that you actually let it sit this way for 1 to 2 months until that whole cycle was complete and you had a more stable substrate. And I guess that's why we do these huge water changes when we want to make the dirt and make the substrate, cap it, plant it, and start enjoying it. But we've got to do these huge water changes because of the big ammonia spike and the detrimental effect that obviously that can have on the plants. So I'm not sure what we're going to do yet here. I don't know if we're going to wait the 1 to 2 months. Probably not. No, probably not. I'm impatient like everybody else is. We're in a give-me-it-now society, so we'll see. We'll see. I've got the other tank to work on, so maybe we'll let it sit for a while, and we'll test the levels, and we'll see where it's at. So anyhow, just wanted to mention that. Another interesting thing in the article talked about plants, that if you're going to inject with CO2 and you have a dirt tank, that at this state you can actually plant the plants now, planting the roots and exposing the leaves of the plants, and they'll start growing, in a humid environment planted into this topsoil. They will grow. But when you fill the tank with water, and if you're injecting with CO2, you'll be fine. The plants will have CO2 to use in their process of supplying nutrients to themselves. If you're not injecting CO2, the plants will melt because there won't be any CO2 in the tank for them right away. So that's kind of like summing up what was in the article. That's the basics. I mean, there's a lot of chemistry involved, obviously, in this. But that's where we are. That's where we are. There's a football game on. There's a football game on, the Packers and the Giants. So I'm gonna go watch that. Go help my beautiful wife with dinner, and the tank is done for the week, so we're off to the family activities. So Sunday night we're gonna post these videos, so check them out. Comment, like, dislike. Let me know what you think. Thank you for watching.